We just solved this problem, but I thought we should look at it again using a different approach. The table summarizes results from 976 pedestrian deaths that were caused by automobile accidents. Notice how the table indicates whether the pedestrian was or was not intoxicated, as well as whether the driver was or was not intoxicated. If one of the pedestrian deaths is randomly selected, find the probability that the pedestrian was not intoxicated or the driver was intoxicated. So we want to determine the probability that the pedestrian was not intoxicated. So we'll say P not intoxicated or intox, or the driver was intoxicated. So we'll say D intox. Now we just solved this problem using the probability of a union formula given here below, where the probability of A or B equals the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A and B. But this time, let's use our reasoning skills and the information from the table to determine this probability. Remember, probability compares the favorable number of ways divided by the total number of ways. So we're selecting one pedestrian death and determining the probability the pedestrian was not intoxicated or the driver was intoxicated. Well, because there are 976 deaths, the total number of ways of selecting one pedestrian death would be 976, which would be the denominator of our probability. And now we want to determine the favorable number of ways of selecting one death where the pedestrian was not intoxicated or the driver was intoxicated. So looking at the table, this column represents the number of deaths where the pedestrian was not intoxicated. So these two values here represent favorable ways of selecting one death where the pedestrian was not intoxicated, but we have or the driver was intoxicated. This row here represents the number of deaths where the driver was intoxicated, but we've already counted these 82 deaths as favorable ways, and therefore we only add in these 62 favorable ways. So these three cells represent the favorable number of ways of selecting one death where the pedestrian was not intoxicated or the driver was intoxicated. So the numerator would be the quantity 62 plus 82 plus 606, which would be equal to 750. So the probability is 750 divided by 976. Let's express this using a simplified fraction, then as a decimal, and a percentage. And we'll go ahead and simplify this using the calculator. So we have 750 divided by 976. Press enter. This is our decimal approximation, but let's first find the simplified fraction. So we'll press math, enter, enter. So the simplified fraction is 375 over 488. And for a decimal approximation, we'll say approximately 0.7684, which as a percentage would be 76.84%. If you found applying the probability formula difficult, I hope you'll find this approach helpful. Thank you for watching.